In this video, I'll explore if, else, and match control flow operators in more detail with demos. I'll begin by creating a new project called control flow. I'll do that in my terminal window now. Once at my Rust projects directory in the terminal window, I will type cargo new control underscore flow. Then once that package is created, I'll go ahead and change directories to the control flow package and open that up in Visual Studio Code. Once the project is open in Visual Studio Code, I'll focus my attention on the main.rs program. Inside of the main function, I'll go ahead and get rid of this print statement, and let's go ahead and start by writing a couple simple if-else expressions. The first, I will say if 1 is equal to 2, then I want to print map is broken. Else, I can go ahead and say print everything is fine. Cool. So in this example, the condition of if is the expression 1 is equal to 2, which evaluates into a Boolean type with the value false. Unlike in most languages, if blocks can also act as expressions. So remember that all branches must return the same type for our code to compile. So let's look at another example of that now. I'll define a variable called formal that is equal to true. And then I want to define another variable called grading, which is going to be equal to an if expression called if formal. And so if formal is equal to true, I want to go ahead and print out good evening. Else, if formal is equal to false, I want to go ahead and print out hey friend and add a semicolon at the end of that and also a semicolon at the end of this expression here. So in this example, we can see that the result of the if expression is stored in the greeting variable. And then from that, we're able to use this new if expression to evaluate what to print out as the greeting. You can handle multiple conditions by combining if and else in an else if expression. For example, let's say let number is equal to 6. And then if number modulo 4 is equal to 0, I want to go ahead and print out number is divisible by 4. Else if number modulo 3 is equal to 0, then I want to say println number is divisible by 3. And finally, I can say else println number is not divisible by 4 or 3 and add a semicolon at the end of that. And I can also fix my typo up here. Thanks VS Code for calling that out for me, is not divisible by 3. So here is just a simple example where we can have multiple branches and you can add as many branches as you want if you go ahead and add in that else if keyword. Let's go ahead and look at one more example where we can use match. To begin in this example, I want to define a variable called Boolean, which is going to be equal to true. And then I want to say let binary is equal to match Boolean and then add some braces. So now I'm going to print out all of the possible values, which for a Boolean is really straightforward. I'm going to have either 0 or I'm going to have 1. And then there we have it. I can add a semicolon at the end of that. So now we define Boolean is equal to true. So when it comes down to evaluate the match statement, it's going to go through these two different arms here. So it's going to skip the first arm since that is equal to false and then select true as the matching arm. So then the value printed out will be 1. So there's a few examples of using if, else, and match in action. Continue to explore on your own to get more familiar with these expressions.